Tina Arena is back and she joins me now, and it's so good to see you.
Thanks, Lorraine. It's nice to see you too.
Classic song.
It was.
Absolutely. It is. I know it is. It still is. Of course it is. Yeah. So look, back, things going really well. New album's out, 11 it's called.
Yes.
11 has got some significance for you, the number, hasn't it?
Well, it's my 11th original record. I've done more than 11 records, sure. But, you know, that's sort of as a new body of work.
Right.
So, and it's I'm the first of the 11th, is my date of birth.
Ah.
So 11 is a number that is very prominent in my life.
Sort of makes sense. Now, look, what's all this about you getting a massive French award? What was all that about and how did that come to be?
There's a whole lot of hogwash, really.
Not at all.
I think it's basically, I've spent sort of the late 90s after England, I went over to France and I'd recorded the soundtrack to a film called The Mask of Zorro, which was Catherine Zeta-Jones' first film, Anthony Hopkins and Banderas. And that soundtrack, which was written by the late James Horner, beautiful Englishman, was such a big hit. So that kind of opened the doors to France.
Ah.
It stayed in the top 10 for a considerable amount of time. Mm. And that then opened the chapter to the French chapter, really. And I started recording in French. It was a little bit of an experiment.
Mm.
I'm the daughter of Italians, so I grew up speaking Italian and learnt English when I was 5.
Wow.
So could you speak French before you... Look, I spoke very basic school French, but I was very passionate about the language. I had a real curiosity about it. I love languages.
Yeah.
It's music for me.
It's actually, and Italian and French are very musical languages.
Certainly.
They're so beautiful. So beautiful.
So I started recording and then... Wow. It was just sort of been going for a long time too.
Oh, that's great. And Tina, the biggest audience, I guess, you must have had, which was a mere 3 billion, was at the Olympics, of course, in Sydney. 3 billion people.
Yeah.
Wow.
It was a particularly beautiful... I mean, I think most of the Olympic Games openings are extraordinary for their own reason or another.
They're a spectacle.
They're a beautiful spectacle. But the Australian one, there was something really beautifully simplistic about it. There was something very raw about that. And it obviously was due to our Indigenous community, which gave it just a real sense of beauty and simplicity. It was about basics. But I guess getting up and being, you know, representing your country on an international level was a very significant moment.
Absolutely.
And I had just been on stage that year at the Dominion playing Esmeralda in Notre Dame de Paris, so it was an interesting time.
Ah, I bet it was.